Thank you. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth gives way, though the mountains be moved into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble at its swelling. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God will help her when morning dawns. The nations rage, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress. Come, behold the works of the Lord, how he has brought desolations on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the chariots with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our fortress.
Well, good evening to you and Merry Christmas. Are you ready to see the Gettys? We're excited about this night. You know, this is the biggest Christmas event we've had in 2 years. That's a COVID joke right there, all right? Welcome to First Baptist Church. My name is Darren. I'm the senior pastor here, and on behalf of an incredibly wonderful and warm congregation, I want to welcome you to this event. We are so thrilled that you've chosen to be with us tonight. We're excited about what the Lord is going to have in store for us, and we're praying that God is going to speak to you as we worship together and we lift up our voices, because there is but one God. His name is Jesus Christ, and get this, he split time. And he came to earth, God and man in the same flesh, and lived among us. Isn't that something worth celebrating? Amen. So again, thank you for joining with us tonight. I have a couple of announcements before we continue with our time together. First of all, if you need to use the facilities, we have one word of instruction for you. Please, if you will, go back out into the hallway behind you and go to the right or go to the left. The restrooms are on either side of these walls. We're just going to ask that you not go out the front doors on either side. Secondly, on behalf of our congregation, I want to extend an invitation to you to come back and visit us sometime. Our church worships here in this room every Sunday morning at 10:30. You are welcome to attend, especially if you're not actively involved in another congregation. You live nearby. We would love for you to come back. But also, we would extend an invitation for you to come back this Friday. With Christmas Eve happening on Friday at 5 o'clock in this room, we're going to have a candlelight Christmas service. It's open to the community, free, of no cost for you. Come and join with us as we put our attention upon the reason for this season, and that is that God came into this world to redeem us, to save us. We welcome you to come back for that this Friday at 5 p.m. One last thing. If you have any questions about our church, or more importantly, if you have a spiritual question and are not sure about your relationship with God through Jesus Christ, we would extend an invitation to, following our time, to come speak with one of us. After we conclude the concert tonight, off to my right, to your left, you will see a cross, and there will be one or two pastors over there. If you have a question about our church or a faith question, we'll be available for you. We invite you to come with us and have a conversation. Well, with no further ado, I want to invite you to welcome to the stage Keith and Kristyn Getty.
Gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember, Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day. God rest ye merry, gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember, Christ our Savior was born on Christmas Day. To save us all from Satan's power, we were gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Tidings of comfort and joy. Blessed babe was born, and laid within a manger upon this blessed morn. The witch's mother Mary did nothing take in scorn. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Tidings of comfort and joy. And unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same. How that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Tidings of comfort and joy. The shepherds at those tidings rejoiced in much in mind, and left the flocks of feeding in tempest, storm, and wind, and went to Bethlehem straightway the Son of God to find. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. Now to the Lord's praises, all you within this place, and with your love and brotherhood each other now embrace. It's holy tide of Christmas, all another's death we face. Tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Tidings of comfort and joy. It's holy tide of Christmas, all another's death we face. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy.
Heard the hymn. Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born, and he shall see his glory. Within a lodge of tender blood, the tender babe was found. A ragged robe of rabbit skin enwrapped his beauty round. To praise you now, the angel's song ran loud and high. Jesus, your King is born. Jesus is born, and it shall see his glory. Is born in excelsis gloria.
Good evening, everyone. We are just thrilled to be here in this incredible crowd this evening for our first ever concert in Ocala, Florida.
Thank you for joining us tonight.
We are honored to be a small part of your Christmas celebrations, also honored to be a small part of your Sundays. And as we think at the end of this day that believers in every corner of the world today have gathered to sing about Christ, the child who was born, who died and rose, that this weary world can rejoice. And so what a thrill it is to be able to share this evening with our band, with this choir and their conductor, Danny Boy, on an Irish Christmas. And we are just thrilled to be there. Why don't we welcome all of them this evening?
Beginning of our time this evening, we'd love to sing a song that will hopefully bring some calm this evening as we approach one of the busiest weeks in the year, that this evening might afford you an opportunity to truly hear the Christmas story, to understand all that the Lord has done for us in Christ. Last year, we missed traveling with Irish Christmas. We were home in Ireland having a truly Irish Christmas with our kids, and it was just wonderful. We had 10 months there, time with family and friends, enjoying the landscape and having our kids really get to know where we're from. And one of our favorite spots is in the very north coast, a little strip of coastline between Dunluce Castle and the Giant's Causeway. And it's absolutely beautiful. There's a photograph, I think, that Nathan can show you maybe. There it is. And that's one of my dad's beautiful starry night over Dunluce Castle. And some of you might be be familiar with this, but C.S. Lewis, author of the Narnia stories and many other wonderful things, he was actually born and grew up in Northern Ireland, and Dunluce Castle inspired Caer Paravel when he came to write the Narnia stories. And a night like this, and we enjoy gathering together to sing, there's a little passage at the beginning of The Magician's Nephew, which tells the story of how Aslan came to create all of Narnia. And he did it through singing a song. And it's this song then that gives voice to everything else. Listen to these words. Then two wonders happened at the same moment. One was that the voice was suddenly joined by other voices, more voices than you could possibly count. They were in harmony with it, but far higher up the scale, cold, tingling, silvery voices. The second wonder was that the blackness overhead, all at once, was blazing with stars. They didn't come out gently, one by one, as they do in a summer evening. One moment there had been nothing but darkness. Next moment, 1,000,000 points of light leaped out. Single stars, constellations, and planets, brighter and bigger than any in our world. There were no clouds. The new stars and the new voices began at exactly the same time. If you had seen and heard it, as Diggory did, you would have felt quite certain that it was the stars themselves which were singing, and that it was the first voice, the deep one, which had made them appear and made them sing. It's a beautiful picture of Genesis 1, the God who created everything by speaking it into being, and who has given us life and who has given us breath to sing. Just last week, our youngest daughter said to me, she's only 3, "You know, Mommy, God is very, very big. He made everything." And He is, and He did, and that gives us so much courage and hope and purpose and value. And tonight, as we lift our eyes up to the Lord, lift our eyes up to the God who created the starry heavens, who is, yes, so big, yet became so small that He could save us.
Consider the stars in the sky. Look up and wonder, can you count their number? Consider the stars in the sky. Umbrella to hide in, a dance floor of heaven. Consider the stars. consider the star in the sky, diamond in a ring over the child king. Consider the star in the sky, grace he had promised, coming to find us. You're worth more than this, and holds you in his hand. Do not be
afraid. Thank you so much. Well, it's wonderful to be here today for a number of reasons. One of them is that this church has a huge belief in music and the arts and its importance. And it's been great to spend just a little bit of time with the choir and with Danny and what they're doing. But we would love to introduce you to this wonderful band that we get to play with. Would you like to meet these people? First of all, joining us here this year on her first Irish Christmas, Jordan Shellhart is a songwriter with Sony Music, a country music songwriter who's written songs for lots of country artists, Little Big Town and a bunch of others whose names I've forgotten. She also just signed a deal to become a solo artist, which she'll be starting at next year. We've just been able to privilege to have her tonight. She's going to be singing with us later. Please welcome Jordan Shellhart. Beside her, David Rogers is a very talented classical and jazz musician. He's added some brilliant new arrangements to this show this year with Fanon. He's just finished a number of years playing with Keb Mo and Taj Mahal in the jazz world. Please welcome Mr. David Rogers. Beside them, Deborah Clemmie, our first ever band member. Kristyn and I grew up on the north coast of Ireland. We moved to live in the Swiss Alps, and combining the rich beauty of those two places, we moved to Cleveland, Ohio. But while there, we had the privilege of meeting Deborah Clemmie, who is at the Cleveland Institute, wonderful classical musician who will be sharing her music with you this evening. She's also executive director of the touring company, and she looks after all the instrumental and choral programs that we have at the Sing Conference every year. So please show our debt of gratitude to Deborah Clemmie. Beside Deborah is Maggie White. Maggie White and her husband, Zach, over here. Not Fanon in the middle, the one Fanon's not married to them. Zach and Maggie are a tour de force in the Nashville music scene. They're a duo. They're also wonderful players playing fiddle and dancing and writing. And then Zach's going to be singing as well as playing the guitar and having lots of fun this evening. Welcome, Zach and Maggie White. In between the happily married couple is Fanon de Barra. Fanon was involved in my first ever session, recording my first ever hymn 20 years ago. And I've leaned on him for musical advice pretty much every week since then. I don't think we've had many, maybe just in the early years, but we've hardly had a week where we don't talk and do stuff. Fanon was the solo guitarist of Riverdance on Broadway when it was there. He's worked with many of Ireland's most esteemed musicians in history. Please welcome Mr. Fanon de Barra. Across here, we have Mr. Byron House joining us for three concerts. Byron is was bass player for many years for Emmylou Harris and for Dolly Parton and for lots of other musicians. all of whom I've just forgotten tonight. I don't know why I've forgotten them all, but he's a Nashville country music legend, and I'm just delighted to have him joining us tonight. You're going to love his very unique bass playing, Mr. Byron House. Finally, from an island slightly warmer than Ireland, Trinidad, Mr. Wendell Henry is bringing his extraordinary drums and percussion and global and jazz and pop sound and gospel sounds to this evening. Mr. Wendell Henry. Now, each year, I don't know if you ever were at the Irish Christmas show when it played Orlando, but each year the guys do a new interpretation of Sleigh Ride, the Leroy Anderson tune, and they're going to do that tonight. And so your role in this whole thing is very critical, okay? Well, what we need all of you to do is, if you hear, it's like when you go to hear a jazz or a global or folk music concert, if you hear a solo you all like, give them a round of applause. Show them some enthusiasm. Show them some love and Christmas joy, okay? And if you're a little uncomfortable with that, you can just give a polite round of applause where your face has no emotional connection. Imagine you're Presbyterian, okay? And that will be fine. Then when we get to the reels and the jigs, we need you to, clap. You're gonna do three things at once, okay? Three things at once. This is serious multitasking for men, okay? We need you to clap on the beat. We need you to stomp on the beat. And we need you to make a noise with your mouth. So that can be a woo, or it can be a hew, you can be a wolf whistle. You can go say, I don't know, go fiddles, whatever you want. Do you know what I mean? Just make some noise. So to get us practiced and to get this room warmed up a little bit, could we have a quick practice at this? Let's try. Here we go. Stomp the floor. And let's hear some noise. That was really pathetic. Okay. We need you to really give it a lot more, okay? So here goes. Please welcome for the first time to Ocala, Florida, our band. That was fantastic. And I think they did a pretty good job as a crowd, didn't they? Give yourselves a round of applause for being so good. Can't believe it. Kristyn's applauding themselves. Terrible. Okay. So. Yeah. So 10 years ago this Christmas, we had a really, you know, can I just tell you what I love about when you look back at Christmas, we look back at people in our lives who have spoken into them or shown a generous hand or inspired us. Isn't it great to look back and have those people in our lives who we can be grateful for? Such an important thing in the midst of what a season that has been so difficult for so many, to be able to say thankful for them. And I kind of feel about this a little bit, about our good friend, Ricky Skaggs. So anybody heard of Ricky Skaggs? Anyone know who Ricky Skaggs is? I thought you might. He came to the show 10 years ago, and he clapped and encouraged us, and the next year we became friends, and he opened the door for our band to be able to play at the Grand Ole Opry two or three times a year, become part of that community. He encouraged us to think about our Scotch-Irish heritage and how that has influenced music in Heartland America, how it's influenced country music and bluegrass and Appalachian and Americana and gospel songs and all this kind of stuff. And when we've built this friendship, each year he's always made an attempt, he's always come to at least one of the Christmas shows and played. And sort of, so in honor of that 10-year relationship, this year, Kristyn and Ricky recorded this beautiful hymn called Hail Blessed Morn, or Brightest and Best, it's more commonly known. And you can enjoy it over Christmas. It's on YouTube for free or in all the streaming services. But it's just a wonderful hymn. It was written by a man called Reginald Heber. Reginald Heber was most famous for writing a hymn called Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. And Heber was one of Britain's brilliant poets, a classics student at Oxford, who influenced a generation of poets. John Betjeman, many of Britain's finest poets looked to Heber as a hero. But Heber's heart was caught by the gospel of Jesus. And he believed that when someone becomes a Christian, it pushes them beyond their own boundaries, beyond their own borders, to do things in service of others. And he felt called to India, and he went to India and gave his life caring for those less fortunate than themselves, pastoring. He became the Bishop of Mumbai, and died at 41. But an incredible life well lived. And this hymn of his, which looks at the story of the incarnation of Christ, who had everything, giving it up for us, to me, when I think about it and what I know about the guy, it's almost a biographical hymn. So tonight, Zach White is being Ricky Skaggs. And I gotta tell you, he does an amazing job. You're gonna love this. And he's singing it with my wife. And let's enjoy this wonderful hymn.
Hail, blessed morn, see the great mediator down from the region of glory descend. Shepherds, go worship the babe in a manger. Lo, for his guard the bright angels attend.
Say, shall we yield him in costly devotion, fragrance of Edom and offerings divine, gems of the mountain and pearls of the ocean, myrrh from the shine. Low lies his bed with the beast of the stall. Angels adore him in slumbers recline. Wise men and shepherds before him do fall. Wise men and shepherds before him do fall. Christ and Bastard, sons of the morning, dawn on our darkness and lend us thy name. Star in the east, the horizon dawn. Redeemer was laid. Guide where our infant Redeemer was laid.
Jordan's going to come on and help us with this next song. This is a relatively new song, wrote this year with Sandra McCracken, called Pass the Promise, inspired by Hannah's prayer in 1 Samuel, when she not just considers the child or children in her care and the moment in history in which she lived, but she was looking ahead to the promises that were to come, to be revealed in the Messiah. And we wanted to capture some of that. The verses are a call and response style, and then the chorus is this idea of passing the promise onto our sons and daughters. And I am just thrilled, we all are, to see so many kids here tonight. And one of the ways, you know, some of these hymns that we're singing tonight, your parents and grandparents and great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandparents have been singing these. And it's a wonderful way to pass on the good news of the Lord Jesus, to sing it. That's what makes Christmas and Christmas songs so particularly powerful. So we're thrilled that you're here and singing along. This chorus we'd love to teach you. It goes like this. Pass the promise to our sons and daughters, God Most High, God our Father. We bear witness. Really simple. Let's try it together. Pass the promise to our sons and daughters, God Most High, God our Father. We bear witness. And we'd love you to sing in harmony. Who likes singing in harmony here? Lots. And the choir, we're so glad that you're here to help us with this. But let's try it one more time, and don't be shy. Sing out those harmonies. Let's go.
Pass the promise to our sons and daughters, God Most High, God our Father. We
rejoicing from my heart. For in Him my victory's lifted high.
His salvation is my cry.
He has overcome my enemy.
I praise His scorn the enemy.
I delight in His deliverance. Is our God.
All the earth belongs to God.
Do not speak with pride of noble deeds.
The Lord will weigh our every deed.
See, the strong have lost, the weak have gained.
And from our dust
my life He raised.
Pass the promise to our sons and daughters. God Most High, God our Father.
The feet of faithful ones.
He will hold His faithful ones.
But the wicked, they will not prevail.
Not by might will man prevail.
He is coming soon to judge the earth.
He is coming soon to judge the earth.
For the Lord gives power to His king.
All strength to His anointed
king.
Pass the promise to our sons and daughters. God Most High.
Singing. Thank you, choir. That was just, let's thank the choir. Fantastic. Just, we had three parts then. We had parts going up even higher. That was just so much fun. We haven't had a choir the last few nights, and it's just great to those richness of harmonies that just help singing so much. And good to see you kids singing too. Fantastic. So, absolutely brilliant. In this season of Christmas, we think a lot about the vulnerability of Christ who came to earth in a mother's womb and all that that means. And I asked Jordan if she would share one of her songs. Jordan, as I said, has just this weekend signed a pretty major record deal. She writes songs for the broader culture, but they're songs that are story songs that are captivating. And we got to know her. She's really involved in our church and in the worship teams with Kristyn and all the different people at the church. We got to know her a number of years ago, and it is just fascinating how she tells stories. So I'm going to ask her to introduce a song for us tonight.
Thank you, Keith. This is a song I wrote a few years ago. I had a conversation with my mom where she opened up to me about the beginning of my life, and just sort of processing that, I wrote this song. It's called Near Death Experience.
She told herself it's what she wanted. Must have been late July, early August. She looked up the number and called it. Didn't tell no one. They just try and stop it.
She drove all the way to the clinic downtown. Then she either got brave or chickened out. I had a near-death experience before I was born. I made it out by the skin of my teeth in a break in the storm. She said she was sure I'd be better off, 'cause I needed things she just couldn't provide. But here I am against whatever odds, speculating why she changed her mind. Maybe it was her, maybe it was God. All I know is I'm glad to be alive. Says you don't deserve this, and I know it hurts us both when I'm hurting. But she made a choice, and neither one of us would reverse it. Yeah, near-death experience before I was born. I made it out by the skin of my teeth.
Shell Hart. What a powerful song. We're going to finish our first half with just singing a couple of carols, getting warmed up for the second half. There's only one carol that I possibly think we could sing to follow that, and it's Silent Night. So why don't we stand up? I had the privilege of working with this choir for a short time this afternoon, and Danny has them well prepared. So they're going to lead us, but we're all going to sing Silent Night together. But we want you to sing in harmony, okay? So how many sopranos do we have? Keep your hands down, guys. Great. How many altos? How many ladies can sing the alto part? If you know the alto part at all, ladies, switch to alto for tonight, okay? How many men sing in bass? Good. And how many equally masculine men who just have higher-pitched voices singing tenor? Fantastic. You want to hear big, let's fill this room. This is close to the best singing of the tour so far tonight. So I want this to be the best singing of the tour so far, and of the whole tour, in fact. So here we go, Silent Night. It was first performed, the first hymn on record that was accompanied by a guitar, because the organ had broken down. We got Finon de Barra on the guitar. Let's take it away. Here we go.
Oh, For Maggie, for the band, and for Danny and the choir. Let's hear it for them. Thank you. Please take a seat. It's time for an intermission. Give us 3 minutes before we go, if you wouldn't mind. We are not asking for your money. We just want to tell you about something that we want you to sign up and pray for over Christmas. As you probably, if you followed the Sing Conference that we do, or the Christmas Tour, or the Hymn Tour, or the Family Hymn Sings, or the Global Hymn Sing, or some of the product initiatives we've had this year, you know that we partner with Voice of the Martyrs. And we think it's an absolutely crucial organization. Three reasons. Number one, this, we have had the most extraordinary hour and 5 minutes of singing. Hasn't it just been wonderful? Just the encouragement that it is just to hear your voices singing so passionately. And for Christians in Afghanistan this Christmas, that is not how it's going to be. And that tragedy that has been left there, it has left many, many believers in fear of their lives. And yet at the same time, we have also seen other Middle Eastern countries in the last 20 years for whom the church has grown and at record speeds during these times. So we want you to pray for Afghanistan this Christmas. Secondly, we live in the most exciting generation in history to be Christians. It's incredible to be a Christian today. In 4 of the 6 continents of the world, Christianity is growing at an unprecedented level. But in those 4 continents, there is also extraordinary persecution. Almost 70 countries are what's called red letter countries, where it is where you can go to jail at very least for being a Christian. But with all this growth, we need to say, what can we do to help? How can we pray? And what can each of us be learning? Thirdly, we want to encourage you to support Voice of the Martyrs, because it is an investment in our children and our grandchildren. This is where society, where government and culture is going. It is going to be harder and harder to be a Christian. And so we want to learn from these people. Let's watch this video.
Jesus said to his followers, "If they persecuted me, they will persecute you also." And to this day, all over the world, they still do. But Jesus promised more, that those who suffer for his name's sake would not be forgotten. Today, Voice of the Martyrs operates in 68 countries around the world, reaching out through persecution response, through Bible distribution, and through frontline ministry. We will share their stories. We will mobilize the body of Christ to stand together with our brothers and sisters who face persecution wherever it happens. We will serve our persecuted family through practical and spiritual assistance. And we will carry on the mission of the one who called us, Jesus Christ, who said, "Go and make disciples of all nations, no matter the cost."
To get to share the work of Voice of the Martyrs with you this evening. They have been of great help to us and our family, never mind all the opportunities we have to share it with crowds of people. They have wonderful resources. I'd love to make you aware of them. A monthly magazine, which is a fantastic read, and things that are going on around the world. They have a wonderful prayer calendar we keep up in our kitchen, which is just fantastic. They have a number of animated short films specifically for children that shares the stories of some of the great missionary heroes of the past that have just really warmed the hearts of our girls, and we're so grateful for that. We are bombarded with so much information constantly, day in, day out. This is important, critical, wonderful, well put together information, and we would really recommend it to you and to get involved. You'll have received a little card this evening. We'd ask you just to fill it out, looking for our contact details, and you can drop it into the VOM box just in the lobby area at the merchandise table. And when you do, whether you like it or not, you'll receive one of our CDs. Sorry about that, but you'll get one of those. But they will also send you... Keith, that's ridiculous. Anyway, so you'll CD, but in a few weeks' time, they will send you a copy of the Fox's Book of the Martyrs, which is a wonderful resource to have in your home, to share with your family. We'd encourage you to get involved and to sign up to receive this information. That's what they're just seeking for, and I think that would be a wonderful thing to do. We're going to have our intermission now, so enjoy your rest. We look forward to seeing you back in a few minutes for more singing of carols. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, welcome back, everyone. Please take your seats. We are so excited to be back. Before the second half starts, I'd like to say just a few quick thanks. Obviously, thanks again to this partnership with Museum of the Bible. I hope as many of you as possible can sign up, get the information, and consider praying for them, even if it's just once a week. Do consider doing that. Secondly, a second sponsor to all we do is an organization called Crossway. They're book publishers. We're involved in creating a hymn book with them in 2024. We're involved in writing books with them. And then Kristyn, last year, my wife, recorded the Bible. She recorded all 1,189 chapters. And so now the ESV audio Bible, you can go online and listen to her reading the Bible. So I can be in an argument with her. I can go into my room, lock the door, try to listen to the Bible to get my head right, and there she goes, telling me off again. So it won't be as personal for you, but it'd be fine. Still recommend it. But we love Crossway, good books. And if you're looking for good books for Christmas, also just an encouragement to you to fill your home with him. This event is all about, everybody does their own Christmas show with their own twist. And ours is about the great hymns of Christmas. Our life's work is writing hymns and promoting hymns that help people understand God and this wonderful story of redemption in the Bible, knowing that better. And so I'd encourage you, whether you pick up some CDs here as gifts, whether you go stream online, whether it's our music or someone else's, do fill your homes. Leave here tonight, fill your homes, your cars, your mind with songs of the Lord. Johnny Erickson Tada, I was sharing with the choir earlier, Johnny Erickson Tada, who you will know from her story, that book came out 45 years ago that led to the movie, that led to Johnny and Friends organization. And she wrote it, re-released it, and did a little introductory, did a final chapter, what a lady in her 70s tells herself if she could in her 20s. Looking back at the age she wrote it. And one of the things she talks about is the importance of the songs we listen to. She goes, as she listened to more and more songs that weren't of the Lord, all the lines in her life blurred between victim mentality, self-obsession, not quite telling the truth, lingering on great thoughts of oneself, lingering on bad thoughts of other people. So important, the songs we sing for the health of our lives and our families and our churches. And as such, I just want to say a huge thank you to your church for inviting us. I think you were one of the first people coming out of COVID who wanted to have a Christmas show to invite us. I think Pastor Darren and Danny Boy, your choir conductor for Irish Christmas. Yes, why don't we give Danny Boy and the choir a huge thank you? We are so very grateful. And so far, I will tell you this, okay? We were sitting backstage at intermission. This is concert number 9 on our tour, okay? This week alone, we've played Carnegie Hall, New York. We did Museum of the Bible, Washington, D.C., and a live stream to over 130 countries yesterday. I think this is the best singing of the tour so far. So, and I have not said that at any other concert this tour. So that's absolutely true. That's not a line at all, just in case you're thinking it is not. That encouraged me. So let's sing to one another in the second half. Let's encourage one another as we do that. We're going to, it's called, the second half of our service is an old Irish tradition called the tradition of lessons and carols, where we read through the story and we sing the story. And it's interesting, we were at the Museum of the Bible yesterday, they have a thing on Martin Luther, who wanted everyone to know the Bible in their own language. But he went on to say that the Bible teachers and preachers will explain the Bible, and you will carry the Bible out of church through the songs you sing. So important, isn't it, the songs that we sing? Well, as we prepare for tonight, I want us just to calm our minds down. One of the great things lessons and carols, as I looked at old programs of lessons and carols, taught me, they all have a list of the organ pieces that were played before the service. And that wasn't that wasn't to give classical music some bizarre emphasis. It was because all of us need time to prepare. If we are a lawyer or an accountant or a homemaker or a teacher, we expect strong preparation. And if the worship of God is the most important and highest calling of our lives, so we should prepare to do it well. And Deborah is going to play Kreisler's Preludarium and Allegro. It's going to give us 5 minutes to prepare our minds. I don't know where each of you are tonight. Some of you may be struggling with faith. Some of you may never have had faith. Some of you may be kids who are here because of your parents' faith. Some of you in the last couple of years may just have lost patience with it all. And I can't give you simple cookie cutter answers to all the questions that you might have. But I can tell you that Christianity is unique among world religions and philosophies in God, who came down to earth as man, as a little child, who taught, who lived, who died, who rose, and who is our hope as we look to the future. Government, economy, vaccinations, nothing else is our hope. Our hope is in him. And so let's prepare our minds and let's welcome Deborah Clemmie as we start the second half.
Thank you. that mourns in lonely exile here, until the Son of God appears. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel. Of hell, thy people save, and give them victory o'er the grave. Rejoice, rejoice, Emmanuel shall come to thee, O Israel.
Was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning, and through him all things have been made. Without him, nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all men. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not understood it. Let's stand together.
Let us find our way. Emmanuel. This the Christ who was long foretold, though in the shadows of Bethlehem. Promise of dawn, now our eyes behold. God most high in a manger lay. Lift your voices and now proclaim. Great and glorious, love has come to us. Join now with the hosts of heaven. Come we to welcome Emmanuel, King who came with no crown of thorn. Helpless he lay, the invincible maker of
half, we shared a song inspired by Hannah's song. And hundreds of years later, the promise is revealed in the coming of Christ. And Mary's song echoes some of Hannah's thoughts, these timeless thoughts, the things that we hold fast to, that we believe in, that the darkness cannot overcome. And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord. And my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed, for he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud and the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham, and to his offspring forever.
Blessing, for his bed a cattle stall. Infant holy, infant lowly, there he lay the hope of all. Heaven's song has pierced the darkness. See, our God has come to save us. Christ the child is Lord of all. Christ the child is Lord of all.
Four and four. is something a little bit different here. We, and the first half had Hannah's song. We read Mary's song. This is now Anna's song. Been inspired in this last year of finding some of those great passages of the great women of faith in the Bible who passed on these promises, who lived faithful lives and pointed to the Savior. And Anna, she was a prophetess who for many decades prayed and fasted night and day in the temple, eagerly waiting for the revealing of God's salvation in Christ. And then her eyes finally set their sights on Christ. So this song captures some of that story. While we were home last year, we were inspired by some of the Ulster Scots or Scots-Irish musical traditions and also language, some of the dialects. And I found a wonderful little copy of the Gospel of Luke in this Ulster Scots dialect. Scotch-Irish dialect, and I found the story of Anna, and I was also listening to the walking song tradition in Scotland of the ladies, walking, W-A-U-L-K-I-N-G, where they would gather freshly made yarn or tweed, and they would wash it, and then they would go around a large wooden table, and they'd gather it in their hands, and they'd pass it to each other, hitting it on the table, making a real fun little rhythm as they did that to dry it out and fluff it up and get it ready for use. And they would sing to the rhythm of the thumping as they did. Often it was gossip from a neighboring town, which is not probably the most productive thing to do, but it was entertaining, I guess. But I thought it would be a wonderful thing to try and inspire a new song. This is a new little folk song based on Anna with the Ulster Scots dialect. And we're going to sing it. The ladies have come forward, and that's going to be fun. Instead of a big wooden table, going to use an Irish drum. So that will work, I think, for this. And in the song, it will be new to many of you. The chorus is pretty simple. We'd invite you to join with us as we sing this song about Anna. There was a wee widow woman called Anna, 84 year old.
84 year old.
A prophetess married to her man for 7 years.
7 years, 7 years, afore he died.
She would stop in the house of God, praying and fasting night and day.
Night and day, night and day, she'd fast and pray.
Looking forward to Jerusalem, being set free.
Telling them about the wind.
Broken-hearted, the Savior comes to the crushed in spirit. Our flesh may fail, the storms assail, but He is my strength and song forever. The Lord draws near through the night of waiting, the promised child and His hope fulfilled. We share in Christ, the bread of life. We know Him and make Him known forever. And all my heart rejoices, rejoices, as angels lift their voices to proclaim. The Lord will come, our returning Savior, the blessed one we have waited for. The shroud of fear, the veil of tears, now pulled from our hope-filled hearts forever. And all my heart rejoices, rejoices, as angels sing their voices to proclaim. Praise be to God, redemption resounds to all the In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region, there were shepherds out in the field keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those with whom he is pleased." I invite you to stand with us and let's sing together.
Joy has dawned upon the world. From creation, God's salvation now offered.
Mother's breast, Father.
please be seated. We have just a few songs for you as we come to the end of our evening together. And thank you so much for your warm hospitality today. We had a very, very long bus ride, and we're so grateful to our crew and our team who got us here and set everything up at record speed for us to be able to sing together tonight. So we're so grateful, Daniel and Sarah and all the team. Thank you. The two readings from Luke, at the very beginning of that book, Luke writes that these things are written so that we might know the truth of them and hold fast to them and to keep telling them. For some of us, we have known these things, and each Christmas is another reminder of their truth, of their importance, of the fact they are the only hope that we have. But I'm thinking of children here tonight, and these things are still new and growing in your minds and imagination, and we hope that you have heard a little bit more of this God of the Bible and the hope that we have in the Lord Jesus. I was only 4 years old whenever I became a Christian, and so much of how I understood and expressed my faith was through singing, and I'm so happy to see you here singing tonight doing the same. The ground we stand on is but a tissue between this life and the next. The urgency of these things are so great that we know them, that we have confidence in them, that they give us courage, and that we share them and don't give up meeting together to remind each other about them. Listen to these words from Malcolm Guite, beautiful sonnet. O come, and be our God with us. O long-sought witness for a world without. O secret seed, O hidden spring of light, come to us wisdom, come unspoken name, come root and key and king and holy flame. O quickened little wick so tightly curled, be folded with us into time and place. Unfold for us the mystery of grace and make a womb of all this wounded world. O heart of heaven beating in the earth, O tiny hope within our hopelessness, come to be born, to bear us to our birth, to touch a dying world with new-made hands, and make these rags of time our swaddling bands.
As iron, water like a stone, snow had fallen, snow on snow. In the bleak midwinter, long ago.
As the Lord has
Let's hear it for this incredible band. Let's hear it for the Irish Christmas Choir and their conductor, Danny Boy. Let's hear it for all the volunteers of this church and the crew who did an amazing job pulling together today.
Thanks so much for joining us tonight. Please have a seat. We'd love just to sing a little blessing to you as you go.
God grant you peace.
this Christmas time.
Ocala,